For today's short tips and tricks, I wanted to show you how yarn actually reacts with different knitting needle sizes. How it looks on a 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So we're going 2 below and 1 above the recommendation. To maybe do a little theory before. So the bigger your needle size is, the bigger the loops will be. So if you see this, it's 8 millimeters of diameter. So your loops will be very big and airy. Whereas if you have a smaller needle, you will kind of have also a smaller loop and it will be much tighter together. How that looks when you're knitting, I will show you in some stockinette samples. I'll be using the 12 stitches. Now we will cast on 12. And since we're doing stockinette, my first row will be purls. And now I'm a very tight knitter, so my yarn will be very tightly around the needle. If you're a loose knitter, it might have a little bit more room, or even more tighter knitter, such as my mom, which it's very snug around the needles. Okay, so I will be knitting a few rows and come back to you to show you the gauge. So these are with the 8 needles. You can see when I pull and stretch them a little bit, they're a little bit loose. So what you can see is you can kind of see through them. So I wouldn't say it's that bad. Like, it's not for a summer sweater look through type, but it is a little bit loose. I mean, these are the 8 needles. So I'll do the 7 needles and come back and show you how that looks like. Okay, so in my hands, I feel that the 7s are a little bit smaller. Here, the loops are getting a little bit smaller. Everything as expected. Meet you at the end when I've done the gauge. This is also 12 stitches. So I'm going to do them all 12 stitches and show you the result of that. So this is the 7. So it is a little bit tighter. Let me just get the 8 to compare. So when you see the 8 square, it's just minimal larger. If I would block it, it's actually a little bit higher. And then you can notice, like, when I pull, when I drape it, this is much tighter. So it's still like, this is what I would probably go for as a normal knitting needle size, but let's see how the 6 goes. So they did recommend 6 or 7, and we're at the 7, so it would be totally fine with this. This I would actually use for a loose sweater or something, so it's not bad. So in comparison, we have the 7 and the 8. And they look a little bit similar, but this one feels a little bit tighter and pulled together. So if I were to block this, It looks very straight and not so whole, like I can't see through it. Okay, so let's try out the number 6 needle. Now, I do have the 6 needles on, and here again, I'll cast on 12. So here with the 6 needles, we see it's already getting a little bit more bunched up. I feel the needles are much smaller laying within my hands. So with the jumbo needles, you feel a real difference, but starting at maybe 6, it starts to feel more normal. Yeah, and then starting 3, it feels tiny sometimes. So here I'm already noticing sometimes I poke through like the yarn. But that's all manageable. Okay, so I'll meet you back when I knitted some rows and bind it off and show you what I found. So now finishing the 6 needle, this is what we have. And it is a bit more tighter, so it's not that drapey. So it's very stiff. Let's compare it with the 7. This is the 7 versus the 6. So this is a little bit more drapey. Maybe you can see the stiffness. And if I compare it to the 8, so size, you're seeing a bigger difference now. And also the stiffness. So this, when you like roll it, this, maybe you can see how stiff it actually is. We're already seeing some differences. Okay, so now let's try with the 5 millimeter. So here we can see it's a little tighter than the 6, and it's getting very small. So now I also finished the 4. So as we can see, it's even more tight than the 5. And I thought since our 8 wasn't actually that bad, I would go one further up. And I don't have 9 needles, but I use 10. And so we can see the difference. So here we have the 10. It's quite like you see through. So this would be good, for example, for a bikini top, like if you want to make those nice and airy sweaters. Now 8 doesn't look bad. It's still a little see-through for your normal garments, but it would totally be okay to knit something with 8 needles in this yarn. 7 is where we're getting to the more normal knitting. So this is when you want to make some garments that aren't too much see-through, that good for scarves, for anything. Our number 7. Our number 6 is starting to get pretty tight. So with my knitting style, it's already kind of tight, as you can see, which means it gets stiffer in the way it moves. So for this, maybe I would make something that's not supposed to move too much, like mittens, or maybe like one of those muffles to keep your hands warm. because this is like getting kind of stiff. If it were a sweater, I think like it would kind of not fall nicely. So for my knitting style, a six is pretty tight. Now coming to the five, of course, this is going to be even tighter. This is where we get into the region of maybe making a basket or something that has to be stiff. Even maybe a pillowcase might be nice. And these are four. So four is definitely very small, very mush, like smushing the yarn together. So it's totally fine if you want to make a basket or something, for example, to hold your toiletries, a bag, anything that's supposed to be stiff. Okay, so these are the different sizes and how your needles actually influence the yarn and the knitting. Then this shows again how important it is to create gauges, so that you can see how the yarn is reacting with your knitting, with your needle size choice, and also for the measurements if you create garments. So glad to show you around. If you like this, please subscribe and hit the like button. Thank you.